So I've been working on sculpting Horace, the bookworm bench. You can still see parts of his armature or framework are exposed here. And so the basic process of it was I welded an armature together with wire that came from Taylor Fence. It's what they use to make chain link with. And so it's kind of an easy wire to bend. So you can bend it in the shape that you want, weld it together to kind of create a cage, and then fill it with spray foam insulation. And I'll make a more detailed video about that sometime too, but that's just kind of a basic description of the process that I go through to create an armature. I fill it with the foam insulation because that not only keeps it a lot lighter weight than it would be if it was solid epoxy and cement, but it also saves on materials too. Yeah, and even when I have like little scraps of extra foam from carving sculptures and stuff, like you can see some of the pink in here maybe. Some of this is kind of pink in here, and those are actually scraps that came off of sculptures that I sculpted with the foam, the pink foam insulation. And so I'll save those scraps and put them in the armature. And you know, I try to reuse things as much as I can. Yeah, so anyways, that's just the basic process of how I make an armature. And after that, I started laying my epoxy cement mixture over Horace in just kind of a consistent layer. Got a layer of epoxy on here, but you can see that it's a little bit uneven. This is not a super even layer because the armature is not extremely even. So you have to kind of decide how precise you want to get in the armature and how precise you want to get in the cement and epoxy, because the more precise that you make your framework, the more or the less you'll have to like finagle it in the epoxy. But you know, I really enjoy sculpting with the epoxy, and so I kind of have a mixture of it. I try to get, you know, the basic shape down in the armature, but I'll kind of smooth it out and finish it up with the sculpting epoxy. Yeah, so I've got a layer going here, and what I want to do is I want to even this up and get a nice even texture on it. Now you can see I've already textured it. Part of that is because I don't know which parts I might want to leave. You know, some of these parts like here might be finished, but then I might kind of smooth it over this way. So, you know, I don't want to be left with having to carve that shape out later because it wouldn't look the same. So I've done an all-over texture, and the other reason that I've done that is that kind of pushing the epoxy and cement in there, like to make that texture, it makes it stick better to the armature. So it's just kind of a good thing to do anyway. But now it's time to even it up. So lots of people use soapstone to mark on their work, which I like to do with metal because it doesn't go away as easily when you're welding, because when you're welding, chalk and stuff will just like burn away. But I have this piece of chalk here, and that's what I really love. I just get like a pack of the basic sidewalk chalk, and you can get a bunch of different colors. And I'll use that to like do math on my table for proportions and things like that. And I'll use it to mark up my sculptures. So what I'm gonna do is I've created this kind of, these lines that kind of go parallel here all over the bookworm. And so what I'm going to do now is mark sections using these lines. So I'm going to mark up some sections, and then I'm going to give each of them kind of their own roundedness. So you'll see about all that, but I'm just going to use this chalk to mark these sections. I want to start with some nice lines to start with, to really mark out like where those sections are going to be. And so I'm choosing about 3 of my parallel lines at once. Some of these sections might end up being a little bit bigger than others, but that's okay. And the great thing about chalk too is that you can always refine it later. It's just basically a powder, so if you need to erase it, you can just get like a little paper towel or something and just erase it. No big deal. All gone. All right, so I've just kind of marked out some of the different sections that I'm going to do, and then I'm going to sculpt them so that they're kind of rounded, and then bring this texture back in here. So yeah. So I marked off each of these sections, and with each section I am kind of making it a little bit of a curvature so that it looks a little bit more realistic. We're kind of echoing these lines here. And as far as texture goes, I looked up like an actual worm texture on Google, and trust me, you do not want to do that. You don't want to actually look up what a worm looks like under a microscope, because it looks friggin' scary. Ah! And this is supposed to be a bench for kids. It's Horace the Bookworm. He's like a very nice worm, and we don't want him to like scare the kids. So I've just kind of made up my own texture a little bit, which is sort of like based on real life, but like worms don't really have these little dots in here, but I kind of liked them. And what I'm using to create those are these little doming tools. These are part of my doming block set, and what they're actually for is for hammering domes into sheet metal, and I use them for that too. So I'm trying to keep them very clean, but what I'm doing is I'm just kind of pressing them into the epoxy. So yeah, with each of my little sections here, I take some cement and epoxy mix, and I'm kind of just smoothing this over each section and kind of rounding it in the middle here. So on the edge here, we're really flat, really flush with the original layer, and then we're just coming up and over and then back flat again on this other side. Doing this, I'm kind of also just evening up any of the unevenness that was there from the first layer. And again, that just happens because, you know, the armature is a little bit uneven. Pushing at the same time, smoothing and pushing to make it all very even and not lumpy. Adventure with me today. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and thank you to all of those of you who have. If you want to try some epoxy at home, you can get it at paviajustinian.com/art supplies.
and we'll see you next time.